Greetings to all. With this video, we'll start learning about the strategies to use in order to cognitively engage students in asynchronous online classes. You all must be wondering about the session's titles. What is the relevance of writing pitch report, IPL, ODI, or T20 in them? You'll get to know about it soon in this video. Asynchronous learning style allows for anytime, anywhere learning. Students can repetitively access the recorded videos or study material posted according to their time convenience. Recorded sessions provide students the time to digest the session content and conduct further research before posing questions in a discussion group. In order to be successful in conducting online classes, an online class needs to be lively. A teacher can be present only in synchronous online class is a myth. It is possible to have teachers' presence in an asynchronous online class too. So, here are some strategies to increase teachers' presence in an asynchronous class setting and boost students' cognitive engagement. So, first is, this is me, introduction videos. The first step to making an engaging online class is to beef up the introductions. Here's how to do it. Create a short, maybe 2 to 3 minutes video of yourself for your class. The video should not be just about who you are as a faculty member, but it should be more about who you are as a human. It should have information about your interests, your passions, your approach to learning and teaching. Once you post your introduction video, you can now ask your students to create their own, which could consist of just pictures and text that represented who they are, and then make them share it to the group. It could help you to create a connection with your students and build a sense of community. Here is my small introduction video as an example. Hello participants, here I am to introduce myself. I am Ramya Jain. I believe in learning with fun, so I try to keep my lectures more informal. I like to interact with my class and share my personal experiences. So I thought, why not to share my own introduction video to interact with you all in this asynchronous session. Talking about myself, I like to play badminton and basketball, although I'm not very good at it. And I also have keen interest in painting and dancing. I wish to travel and experience adventurous activities around the world. There's much more that I can share about myself, but let's cut it short here and continue with the online sessions. Thank you. We now move on to the strategy number 2. It is, try to be brief and crisp. I would like to bring to your notice that the student's attention span is not more than 20 minutes. And at the top of it, the learning time for screencasting is short too, that is 15 minutes. Hence, in order to prevent your students from zoning out, it is important to chunk or break down information into smaller pieces. It will help you organize your content in a logical way. So be careful to keep the videos crisp and short, maybe ranging between 15 to 20 minutes. Next strategy is not your typical module or the study material. This strategy will give the relevance of writing, pitch report, IPL, etc. in the titles for the ongoing sessions. If you are creating modules that make up your course, just change your modules to something fun, something outside the typical pedagogical language box. So instead of naming your modules as module 1, module 2, etc., you might change the names to complement some type of a theme. It could be video game levels like mission 1 for unit 1, level 1 for chapter 1, and so on. Or Netflix themed like trailer for brief introduction of unit, season 1 for unit 1, episode 1 for chapter 1, and so on. Or for all the cricket fans, you can change the module names to IPL for unit 1, innings 1 for chapter 1, and so on. It doesn't matter what theme you choose, but by being creative and unique, you can add fun element to the course and spark students' engagement. I have used the cricket theme for my sessions. Here is another creative strategy for you. Hide some Easter eggs. What is an Easter egg? It is some type of a hidden clue that you place within your recorded lectures or other documents that students must view or read for their asynchronous work. So, for example, within your recorded lectures, you could provide a link which takes the students to their assignment or quiz or to some study material. It could be a hint to the questions in the upcoming tests, or it could be answers to the queries raised by students. Let your students know ahead of time that there are Easter eggs scattered throughout the course and they should keep an eye out. It is up to you whether you want to give a reward or a prize for finding them, maybe in the form of marks or attendance or recognition, or you can just use them to add a surprise element to your course. These Easter eggs don't have to be anything extensive or quite frequent throughout the course, because just knowing the fact that there are hidden messages, students will find learning more fun and engaging. Here, I would like to notify you that there's an Easter egg hidden in one of the following videos. Last but not the least, we have online discussion board. A discussion board is an online discussion site where people can hold conversations in the form of posted messages. Discussion boards not only fuel students' engagement, but they also facilitate critical thinking and a sense of community in online environments. It is here where students explore varied segments of the course, interact with each other, and can touch on areas of the course not included in the syllabus. Here, I would like to bring into limelight a fact, that is, a successful discussion isn't measured by the quantity of students' responses, but it is measured by the quality of students' responses. And being able to conduct a quality discussion, it requires instructors' engagement and thoughtful construction of discussion assignments. Always remember, students' engagement stems from instructors' engagement. So, here are some checkpoints to make a quality discussion. First, the first discussion in an online course should serve as a way of introducing students to the use of discussion forum, including its technical issues and net etiquette. The discussions should be built around the course learning objectives in order to ensure its relevance. The discussion boards have to be a graded situation so that the students will take them seriously. You can use any of the following criteria for grading. Like, it could be demonstration of an understanding of the topic through critical thinking. It could be uniqueness of contribution or community building through collaboration and connection with other students, or proper demonstration of net etiquette and mechanics of writing, or it could be timeliness and participation with post or replies. In order to promote higher level of thinking, ask students to pose a question related to the topic to further stimulate discussion in the forum. Direct students to reply to fellow students with substantial constructive feedback to ensure a continuous healthy discussion. When participants become disrespectful to each other or they demonstrate rude behavior or post any inaccurate information, the facilitator needs to intervene as quickly as possible. Respond to students' discussion post wherever required. While most students will eagerly respond to each other, but your constant presence will remind the students of your sincere interest in the course. This will give you the opportunity to continuously push discussions forward and keep the course discussions on track. Lastly, after all the students have posted and replied, post a closing remark for the forum. Make sure that you acknowledge students' points of view, address any area that needs further clarification, and add new content to augment understanding of the topic of discussion. With the discussion on discussion forums, we come to the end of this video. I have tried to adopt all the said asynchronous strategies for my sessions in order to demonstrate its impact. If you have any suggestions, feel free to communicate through the discussion forum created for today. I request you all to watch the following sessions. थैंक यू।